Molten salt reactors for the production of electrical power were studied at Oak Ridge National Laboratory from 1957 to 1960. The Molten Salt Reactor Experiment, MSRE. Preliminary design of the reactor began in May 1960. The molten salt fuel for this reactor is radically different. Salt flows from a pipe which is heated to keep the salt molten. At 1200 degrees Fahrenheit, the salt does not react with air. It flows like water, but does not boil. MSRE is a circulating fuel, graphite-moderated, single-region reactor. During operation, fuel, which is nearly as fluid as water, enters the flow distributor near the top of the vessel and spirals downward in turbulent flow through the space between the vessel and core can. The fuel is then directed upward in laminar flow through channels machined in graphite bars of the core matrix, where heat is generated by the fissioning of uranium-235. A simple control system of three flexible control rods helps to regulate the power and temperature. The salt, which is now 1210 degrees Fahrenheit, is discharged by the fuel pump and flows through the primary heat exchanger and then back to the reactor. Gaseous fission products are removed from the circulating salt stream in the pump tank. Coolant salt is circulated through the heat exchanger and leaves at 1070 degrees Fahrenheit. Heat from the coolant salt transferred to air in the radiator. Cooling air is forced across the radiator and up the stack. The molten salt is held in the whole system by special freeze valves. The fuel is composed of lithium, beryllium, zirconium, and uranium fluoride salts. The coolant is a fluoride salt mixture like the fuel, but it does not contain uranium or zirconium. Piping and components are fabricated from Hastelloy N, a special nickel-molybdenum alloy developed at Oak Ridge, which has good resistance to corrosion attack by fluoride salts. Dished heads for the reactor vessel were cold-pressed from 1 1/8-inch thick Hastelloy N alloy plates. The reactor vessel's fuel inlet was also cold-formed, as were most of the Hastelloy N alloy parts. Assembly of the reactor vessel began in mid-1962. The reactor core of nearly 600 vertical graphite bars was carefully assembled on a graphite lattice within a clean room. The 5-foot diameter reactor with core and control rod assembly weighs about 9 tons. Tanks provide safe storage of salt mixtures with bayonet tubes and steam dome in which fission product decay heat is removed by flashing water to steam. The thermal shield is a double-walled stainless steel vessel which surrounds the reactor. The annulus is filled with water and carbon steel balls for primary shielding. Special freeze flanges in the fuel salt circulating piping permit the removal and replacement of major components, such as the heat exchanger. All components and connecting piping in the salt circulating systems are heated electrically to maintain the system above the salt freezing point of 840 degrees. It is planned to remove impurities and recover uranium from the fuel salt in this on-site processing facility. The sampler enricher is a unique device for sampling and adding fuel during full power operation of the reactor. A power-driven cable remotely lowers a small bucket into the liquid salt of the pump bowl, and then raises the bucket into a manipulator area for transfer to a shielded container. More than 300 samples have been obtained routinely by this method. Fuel is enriched by lowering a bucket of enriched U-235 and dissolving it into the circulating fuel salt stream. This eliminates the need for excess fuel reactivity. Another feature of the MSRE is its high-speed digital computer. With the final addition of 680 grams of enriched uranium into the fuel stream by the sampler enricher, the molten salt reactor experiment went critical on June 1, 1965. After final preparations, power operations began early in 1966, one of the highest temperature reactors operating today. It has been demonstrated that MSRE can be operated safely and reliably. Maintenance of radioactive equipment accomplished with minimum difficulty. Nuclear characteristics were extremely close to predicted values, and the system was dynamically stable at all power levels. Graphite and Hastelloy N specimens similar to these have been removed from the reactor core. Examination indicated no deleterious corrosion or structural change after salt had been circulated in the fuel system for more than 6,000 hours. The fuel proved to be stable to radiation and heat. The laboratory's important goals of nuclear reactor development converge, the search for a stable fuel at high temperature and the capability of providing an infinite supply of electrical power at low cost.
The laboratory initiated a program to develop component maintenance and replacement through remotely controlled operation. Mock-up of a small reactor system, 20 thermal megawatts in size. The reactor is connected to the primary piping circuit by 2 6-inch mechanical joints of the freeze flange type. Specially designed adjustable spring supports permit all piping to expand or contract freely without overstressing the pipe. To remove and replace a component, it must be possible to break and remake pipe connections to extremely leak-tight specifications. Freeze flange is used. Such a joint takes advantage of fused salt properties to form a frozen seal between flange faces. This seal is backed up by a conventional metal O-ring, which seals in the fission gases and serves as a leak monitor. Flanges are held together by two-sectioned wedge clamps. A 1/16-inch gap exists between the faces. It is in this volume that the salt seal is formed. Pin and funnel guides align the flanges during remote assembly. In removing the motor, pump, and reactor, the motor is first disconnected electrically by the remote manipulator. 3 bolts holding the motor and pump spool units together are loosened with a pneumatically operated impact wrench. The motor is lifted from the pump, removed from the cell. 4 jack bolts are actuated to break loose the seals between the pump rotary and stationary elements. An eye bolt is inserted in the pump shaft to facilitate its removal by the crane. The pump flange O-ring gasket is the final piece of equipment removed in this setup. Total time for removal of the motor and pump, 6 hours. In removing the reactor core vessel, 23 thermocouple and heater leads are first disconnected. Jack control handles atop heat exchanger dollies are turned to separate the flange faces and to permit lifting of the reactor vessel. Following attachment of a lifting jig, the reactor vessel is carefully raised from its support stand and removed. Another component designed for remote installation is the electric preheater. Units heat loop piping to 1200 degrees Fahrenheit prior to filling the loop with fuel. As the preheater lifting handle is pulled, the hinged section spread out and the unit is withdrawn. The replacement heater is then lowered and locked into position by pushing down on the handle. Operations indicate it is feasible to remotely remove and replace components of a molten salt reactor without direct or semi-direct manual assistance. The life expectancy of reactor components is estimated to be years. The 36 hours required in replacing the most difficult component in the mock-up, therefore, constitutes a negligible cost item if such efficiency can be achieved on a real molten salt reactor.